Hello everyone, in this video we are going to be looking at filters in Fourier space. So we've seen the previous video how to interpret the Fourier transform and the image that we get in Fourier space and how it represents spatial frequency. Now we are going to use that Fourier space to create filters, so manipulating the image in Fourier space before converting it back to the regular image space and looking at the results of the filters. So let's have a look at the notebook. So I'm starting with a notebook that has the same Fourier methods that I've used in the previous one. So to convert image into Fourier space with the Fourier transform and back to the regular image space. In 2D, and yeah, I also still have the 1D function, even though I will not use them here, and the method to get the amplitude and the phase of the Fourier image. So if I take the origin, the airplane image that I used before, we can see, as in the previous video, the Fourier amplitude. So here it's the log of the Fourier amplitude in order to see the signal better, and the phase. And we can see in the Fourier amplitude the lines here corresponding so to peaks in the Fourier signal, and which correspond to the different spatial frequencies of the patterns that are present in the image. So here we have a very strong, relatively strong horizontal signal here corresponding to the horizontal patterns, so that can be found here. And we have also different orientations here corresponding to the main orientations of the patterns that we have, of the regular pattern that we have in the image. Of course, we have also lots of smaller peaks a bit everywhere. A real image will always have a very complex Fourier signal, but the main lines give us the idea of the main directions and frequencies of the signal in the of the image. So how can we use now this space to create filters? Well, the basic idea generally when we look at filters in Fourier is that we are going to create a mask on the Fourier image. For instance, if you want to create a low-pass filter, so that to blur the image, the idea will be to remove all of the higher frequencies and so to only keep the central region of the Fourier signal, and then to convert back to the image space and to in order to get an image that will have the same signal but without the high frequencies. So how can we do that? Well, first we can create a mask to initialize with zeros everywhere, and that will have the same shape as the image. And then what we can do to begin with is just keep a square that will be the center of the image here, and that will have a certain size. So let's define a size of let's say 30 at the moment, and we'll see what it does. And we start at the center and take a region, so a square region around the center of the image, and the same in the horizontal dimension. Oops, that shouldn't be a comma, it should be column. 1 plus size. Then we can create our new filtered Fourier image by multiplying our Fourier signal, so F is the result of the Fourier transform, by the mask. And then we can get the output image, so the reconstructed image from the Fourier signal, using our inverse Fourier 2D method here for F2. So let's take all of that, just to have the three images. And now what I will display is the original image. I want here the F2 amplitude. So I want to see the amplitude of the new Fourier signal. And here I'm going to show the results. And so I don't need a grayscale here. So what did I do wrong here? Yeah, I did not set any value here, so this should be set to 1. Okay. So first thing here, we can see that the Fourier amplitude, we have a problem here, which is that we are doing the taking the logarithm of a signal with zeros almost everywhere. So logarithm of 0 does not work very well. So we are just going to take the logarithm of the signal plus 1, so that it puts at 0 everywhere we masked, and we have the signal here in the middle. So that's just for display purposes. What's used for the reconstruction is still the signal with zeros almost everywhere. And so what we can see here is that we have removed so the higher frequencies. If we change the shape, so the size of this mask, if we take a higher size, we will remove less frequencies and have something that is much closer to the original signal. If we take a very small size, we'll have an image that is almost completely blurred and we really only keep the very low frequencies. One thing that you can also see is that the output image does not look quite right. There is a lot of patterns here that seems to be artifacts and that appear. And the reason for that is that the mask we've done here is very sharp. So we have very sharp edges that are creating those artifacts here. So we can do two things to make the result look a bit nicer. The first one is that we can, instead of using a rectangular shape for the Fourier mask, we can try to use a circle that will have more of an effect of really choosing the maximum frequency that we allow to pass through the filter. So one way that we can do that is to use the disk method from the scikit-image morphology module that will allow us to create a disk of a certain size. And so what it will do is that we'll put inside the square of that size. It will put ones everywhere that's inside the disk and zeros everywhere else. And so we'll have it's doing what? Plus one. Oh yeah, it should be plus one here because it does not. So it excludes the last pixel in the range. So here you can see that the mask, instead of being a square, is now a disk. So I'm still having the problem with the sharp edge causing this artifact, but the kind of interpretation of the filter now is a bit closer to what we want, because we are really choosing a maximum frequency that we allow to output. And the other thing that we can do is to add to smooth the mask so that we don't have a sharp edge, but that we have something more gradual. And we could do that, for instance, with a Gaussian filter, and say that our mask is now passed through a Gaussian filter with a certain sigma, so a certain standard deviation. And so if we put something higher here, we'll see that we are starting to have a smooth gradient between the signal that we keep and the signal that we have removed, and we are slowly removing the artifacts in the output image. So we have something that is much cleaner, that really corresponds to a to a low pass filter in this case. So the low pass filter is kind of the basic example of what we can do, but of course we can build different types of filters like that. We can really manipulate the image in much more complex ways. So for instance, one thing we could try to do is to kind of reverse this this filter to use so to create a high pass filter. So this time we remove the central part of the image and we keep all of the higher frequencies. And this in this type of filter, it's always easier to look at the absolute value of what remains. And we see that we can with the high pass filter quickly build an edge detector in this fashion. We could also do more complex things. So for instance, we could decide instead of creating of removing just part of the signal, we could decide to just add some arbitrary frequency to the image. So for instance, if I multiply the values in some region of the Fourier space by an arbitrary value. So let's take, for instance, here from 400 to 450 and from, I don't know, 250 to 300. I can, like, say, to decide to multiply, for instance, by 100. And what I will do with that is, so I'm adding some arbitrary value in some, so I'm basically creating some new, so increasing the value of some frequencies. And what I will see in the output image is that it will start creating, so adding some new patterns to the image corresponding to these frequencies. So in this case, it's a very high, it's a fairly high frequency signal, so it adds this kind of wavy pattern throughout the image. And with this kind of method, we can really manipulate the image in many different ways, some of which may be useful, some of which may be completely useless, as is this one. But sometimes it can be used for different types of manipulations, either as a pre-processing step to make the image look better or to make the image easier to interpret for further processing. So that's it for this video, and I will see you in the next one.